Good morning, students. Today we will recap the thing that we have learned in PowerPoint 2013. Now, as we know, this MS PowerPoint is a presentation software that used to make presentation for personal and professional purpose. Now, this is actually used to create the presentation. There we work with the slides. Slide is an individual pages in PowerPoint, where we can insert the image, word art, video, sound, and also we can format the text by some adding different effects to that text and also to the pictures. We can apply the animations over there. So about every of this content we will discuss in this chapter. So the very first thing I want to say that this is the window of PowerPoint. This is the first window. Whenever we open MS PowerPoint, this is the first window where the left top one is the quick access toolbar. And after that, that is the title bar where the name of the presentation will be shown. In the right side corner, here is the close button. And then after that, this is the ribbon that contains file, home, insert, design, these tabs. In the left side, slide preview pane, you can see where you can see all the slide numbers and thumbnails of the slides. And here is the slides placeholders. And here is the slide stage where we are performing. Here is a view button like reading view, normal view, slide shorter view, different view buttons also there in the status bar. Note and comments, and also zoom slider is present in the status bar. So this is more or less about the PowerPoint 2013 screen. After that, come to the file menu. Whenever we are clicking on the file menu, this option will become in the left side, new, open, save, these options. And when you want to make a new presentation, you will select new, and then you either choose blank presentation or also you can choose any of this themes. Next one is the quick access toolbar. So first content of the PowerPoint window, that is quick access toolbar, that contains the tool that we are randomly accessing. So that is that all icons will be present in the quick access toolbar. So that quick access toolbar we also can customize. How? See, here I have already attached one screenshot that if I am clicking on this arrow, then and there you will get this box that is customized quick access toolbar. And if you are clicking on this, from there you can insert the which functions, which tool you will add to the quick access toolbar. That also you can customize. So actually this toolbar contains all the tools that we are randomly accessing. Next is ribbon. There are multiple ribbons in the PowerPoint. So like home, insert, design, animation, transitions. And when you are accessing 2007 version or any other version, it might be different from this rather than this 2013 version, but the functions, all the functions are same. And also there are some contextual tabs. That tabs are the special tabs with the ribbon that are not visible all the time, like format tab. When we insert a picture or we inserting any shape in that video, audio, in that case this format tab will be added in the right side. Otherwise, at the time we can't see these tabs. Next is this is the slide pane where we can see the where we are working right now. In the left side, we can see the, all the slides number. In the right side, we can see the current slide number. Next is start and open presentation. Like you have already saved one presentation and after that you want to open that presentation, then you will again go to the file tab and then click on open. And after that, from there you can get the access for choosing that particular presentation either from your drive or from your computer, from any location you can edit. Next is editing text. As we know that we can format the text in MS PowerPoint, we can add bullets, numbering, we can add any type of object in the slide also. So let's discuss about it. So very first thing, that the shortcut key for adding a new slide is Ctrl plus M, and also we can use press enter. In the right side, I have shown the screenshot also how to do it by right clicking and then click on the new slide. Or also there are some options like duplicate slides. By that also you can add some slides, but that will be duplicate one. Next is start and saving presentation. So that is more similar than I just now discussed, that when I need to open one presentation, I will open it, or when I want to save it, then also we will go to the file tab. So for saving, for opening a blank presentation also, or already existing presentation, we always go use the file tab. So this all objects we can add in the PowerPoint, like clip art, picture, screenshot, online picture, shape, smart art, all these things we can insert in the PowerPoint. So next, here is the screenshot of transition tab. Using the transition tab, we can give effect between the slides. So when clicking on the transition tab, this window will open in the right side that I have attached here of the picture, and here you will get multiple effects, and from there you can apply it. And duration, sounds, and how it will apply, like on mouse click or automatically, that also you can change from the timing group. Next is animation. So when we want to add effect on the text, we can use this tab. While we are using this tab, there we get one options like add animation. And when we have added, this animation pane will be added in the right side. And from there, different effects, different animation you will get. Here is the list of this animation. All the screenshot I have attached here. This is already we have done, you know very well, but still I have shown some screenshot of this. Like from the effect options, we can also change the direction, we can change the timing by clicking on that particular animation. Next is view. As we know, there are different views, and we can arrange the slides in different views, like in normal view, slide shorter view, reading view, play slide view. So just in the left side corner, top left side corner, there is a normal view. Then here is the reading view. So reading view is that will be attached to a window. Okay, that must be fixed within a window. And in normal view, we can see only the thumbnails in the left side, and in the right side we can see the current slides. Same like that, in slide shorter view, we can only see the thumbnails of the slides, and slideshow view, we can get the audience view, right? We can see the presentation in the full screen mode. So here is some snaps for all the views. You can check it out in the top left corner, normal view. After that, just in the below side, you can see that slide shorter view. Then in the right side, this is the reading view, and after that slideshow view. Also, we can change the slide background by using this format background options. So from here we can either change the color, we can change the size of the text, give some texture effect, give some gradient effect, and also we can use some patterns as a background. Here is the examples of word art. How can we insert the word art? Some screenshot of that I have attached here. So these are the steps. So first we will go to insert, then choose word art option, and then this list will come. We have to choose accordingly.